गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू विथ सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द वेरियस लोब्स ऑफ सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स, हिस्टोलॉजी ऑफ सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस समथिंग अबाउट द ब्रॉडमैन्स एरियाज ऑन द सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स. देर आर वेरियस एरियाज आर देयर हियर इन द सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स विच आर स्पेसिफिक फॉर देयर फंक्शन, एंड दीज एरियाज आर नेम्ड बाई Brodmann. That is why these areas are called as Brodmann's areas. So Brodmann area is a region of cerebral cortex which is defined on the basis of its cytoarchitecture. Psychoarchitecture means organization of cells. Brodmann areas were originally defined and numbered in the year 1909 by Corbin and Brodmann. Some of these areas were given specific names based on their functions. So these areas are also classified according to the lobes here. So today in this class we are going to study about the various areas which are there only in the frontal lobe of cerebral cortex. So this frontal lobe forms 1/3 of the cortical surface. It extends from frontal pole to the central sulcus, and it is limited by below by the lateral sulcus. Now again, this frontal lobe of cerebral cortex is divided into two parts: the precentral part or the precentral cortex, which is situated posteriorly, and prefrontal cortex, which is situated anteriorly. So here you can see the pink color one is the prefrontal area, which is situated anteriorly, and this blue color is the prefrontal cortex, which is situated posteriorly. Okay, so prefrontal area and precentral cortex, prefrontal cortex and precentral cortex. This frontal lobe is divided into two, one is prefrontal and precentral. Then first we will go to the precentral cortex here. Precentral cortex is further divided into three functional areas. One is primary motor area, premotor area and supplementary motor area. This primary motor area and premotor area are situated laterally, and supplementary motor area is situated medially. Here you can see this is prefrontal. We are studying about the precentral area. This precentral area is again divided into primary motor area. Here you can see this one is primary motor area, this is premotor area, which are situated laterally, and there is one more area called as supplementary motor area, which is situated medially. Okay, so these are the divisions of precentral cortex, which is situated posteriorly: primary motor area, premotor area, supplementary motor area. Now we will study first about the primary motor area. Primary motor area, it extends throughout the precentral gyrus and the adjoining lip of central sulcus. Here there are two areas are there included in this primary motor area. They are numbered as area number 4 and area number 4S. Structure of this primary motor area: though this area has all the six layers, the granular layer is thin. Special structural feature of this layer is the presence of giant pyramidal cells. They are called as bed cells in the ganglionic layer. So various fibers of pyramidal tract are originating from these bed cells. The function of this primary motor area: primary motor area is mainly concerned with initiation of voluntary movements and speech. Here in this diagram you can see area number 4 and 4S. These are primary motor areas. Area number 4 and area number 4S. These are primary motor area. So first we see area number 4. It is a tapering strip of area situated in precentral gyrus of frontal lobe. The function of this area number 4 is: area 4 is the center for movement, as it sends all efferent fibers of primary motor area. So it is mainly a center for movements. Then area number 4S. Area 4S is called suppressor area. It forms a narrow strip anterior to area 4. It scrutinizes and suppresses the extra impulses which are produced by area 4 and inhibits exaggeration of movements. So whatever the extra impulses which are produced by area 4 are suppressed by area number 4S. So these are the area primary motor area, area number 4 and area number 4S. Then localization, or also called as homunculus. It is particularly related to area number 4 here. That is why we are discussing this thing. The muscles of various parts of the body are represented in area number 4 in an inverted manner from medial to lateral surface. The lower parts of the body are represented in medial surface, and lateral and upper parts of the body are represented in the lateral surface. That is called as homunculus. The order of representation from medial to lateral surface would be like toes, ankle, knee, hip, trunk, shoulder, arm, elbow, wrist, hand, fingers, and face. However, parts of the face are not represented in inverted manner. So here you can see in area number 4, all the muscles are represented here like this. But only face is not represented in the inverted manner. You can see here toes, ankle, knee, hip, trunk, shoulder, elbow, wrist, hand, fingers, neck, eye, nose, face, lips, jaw, tongue. All these things are represented here. So these are the muscles of all the parts of the body. So area number 4 is controlling the muscles of all the parts of the body here. Okay. Then next we will go to the premotor area. Premotor area, it includes four areas, that is area number 6, 8, 44 and 45. The premotor area is anterior to primary motor area in the precentral cortex. It is situated anterior to primary motor area. The premotor area is concerned with control of postural movements. It controls mainly postural movements by sending motor signals to axial muscles, means the muscles near the midline of the body. So premotor area is mainly concerned with controlling the postural movements related to posture of the body. So here you can see the premotor area, area number 6, area number 8. You can see 6 is again divided into 2, 6A and 6B. And also there is area number 8 and this Broca's area, area number 44 and 45. So all these things are included here in premotor area, area number 6, 8, 44 and 45. Here also you can see area number 8, 6, 44 and 45 you cannot see because this is the medial aspect. So area number 6 is in the posterior portions of superior, middle and inferior frontal gyri. It is subdivided into 6A and 6B. It gives origin to some of the pyramidal tract fibers. Function of area number 6. The first function is, it has got mainly two functions. It is concerned with coordination of movements which are initiated by area 4. It also helps to make the skilled movements more accurate and smooth. Second function is, it is believed to be the cortical center for extrapyramidal system. It is believed that it is a center for the extrapyramidal tracts. The next one is area number 8. This area number 8 is called as frontal eye field. It lies anterior to area 6 in the precentral cortex. It is concerned with movements of eyeball. This area number 8 is concerned with movements of eyeball. That is why it is called as frontal eye field. The next thing is about the functions of area number 8. The frontal eye field is concerned with conjugate movements of eyeballs. This area initiates voluntary scanning movements of eyeballs and it is independent of visual stimuli. It is also responsible for opening and closing of eyelids, pupillary dilatation and lacrimation. Lacrimation means eye watering from the eyes. These are the functions of area number 8. Then next one is, we will come to the Broca's area. Broca area is the motor area for speech. So this area mainly includes area number 44 and 45. Broca area is present in left hemisphere of right-handed persons and the right hemisphere of left-handed persons. It is a special region of premotor cortex situated inferior to frontal gyrus. Function of this Broca's area. Broca area is responsible for movements of tongue, lips and larynx, which are involved in speech. So Broca's area is a motor area for speech because it controls the movement of tongue, lips and larynx, which controls the speech. Then the third one is supplementary motor area. The third one in precentral gyrus, the last one is supplementary motor area. Supplementary motor area is situated in the medial surface of frontal lobe, anterior to primary motor area. So it is situated on the medial surface. The various motor movements are elicited by electrical stimulation of this area, like raising the contralateral arm, turning the head and eye, and movements of synergistic muscles of trunk and lens. The functions of the supplementary motor area. The exact function of this area is not understood clearly. It is suggested that it is concerned with coordinated skilled movements. The next one is the prefrontal cortex. So far we have studied about the precentral cortex. In precentral cortex, again it is divided into three areas: primary motor area, premotor area and supplementary motor area. Now we are coming to the prefrontal cortex, which is situated anteriorly, or it is also called as orbitofrontal cortex. So this prefrontal cortex is the anterior part of frontal lobe of cerebral cortex. It occupies the medial, lateral and inferior surfaces. The areas which are present here in prefrontal cortex are area number 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 23, 24, 29 and 32. Among these areas, the area number 12, 13, 14, 23, 24, 29 and 32 are in the medial surface, whereas the area number 9, 10 and 11 are situated on the lateral surface. So here you can see these areas. On the medial surface you can see these areas. 23 also you can see. And 9, 10, 11, you can see these areas on the lateral surface. Then next one is about the functions of this prefrontal cortex. Earlier, this area was considered as inexcitable to electrical stimulation. Hence, it was called the silent area or association area. But now it is known that the stimulation of this area with low voltage electrical stimulus causes changes in the activity of digestive, cardiovascular, respiratory, and excretory systems and other autonomic functions. It also causes fear. The various functions of prefrontal cortex are: first one is it forms the center for the higher functions like emotion, learning, memory and social behavior. Short-term memories are registered here. Then second one is it is the center for planned actions. Then third function is this area is the seat of intelligence, so it is also called the organ of mind. So this area, prefrontal cortex, is called as organ of mind because it controls the intelligence. Then the fourth function is it is also responsible for the personality of the individual. This area is responsible for the personality of the individual because it controls the emotion and behavior. Then the fifth function is the prefrontal cortex is responsible for the various autonomic changes during emotional conditions because of its connections with hypothalamus and brainstem. So the autonomic system includes parasympathetic and sympathetic fibers. So these are controlled here during any emotional changes. If there is any emotional changes, stress, tension, so vagus nerve, which is supplying as a parasympathetic nerve to the whole GI tract, will get stimulated So that will cause increased secretions there. So it may cause gastritis, excessive salivation, etc. So this is how it controls the. So prefrontal cortex is responsible for all these changes. So this is about the functions of prefrontal cortex.